This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Southern American English or Southern U.S. English is a collection of related American English dialects spoken throughout the southern United States, though increasingly in more rural areas and primarily by white Americans commonly in the United States. The dialects are together simply referred to as Southern Other. Much more recent ethno-linguistic terms within the U.S. include Southern White Vernacular English and Rural White Southern English, a regional Southern American English consolidated and expanded throughout all the traditional southern states since the last quarter of the 19th century until around World War II, largely superseding the older Southern American English dialects with this more unified and younger pronunciation system. Southern American English now comprises the largest accent group in the United States as of 2006. Its Southern accent is strongly reported throughout the U.S. states of Virginia, Kentucky, North Carolina, South Carolina excluding the Charleston area, Georgia, Alabama, Mississippi, Tennessee, Arkansas, and Louisiana, as well as much of Texas, southern Missouri, West Virginia, and metropolitan Jacksonville in Florida. The southern accent's character is also documented to a weaker extent, often identified as a South Midland accent throughout Oklahoma, Maryland, Kansas, the southern halves of Illinois and Indiana, the Miami Valley in Ohio, and in some speakers in Delaware, southern Pennsylvania, and greater St. Louis in eastern Missouri. Southern American English as a regional dialect can be divided into various sub-dialects, the most phonologically advanced ones being Southern varieties of Appalachian English and scattered varieties of Texan English. African American Vernacular English AAVE has many common points with Southern English dialects due to the strong historical ties of African Americans to the region. Speech example: an example of a Texas-raised male with a rhotic accent. George W. Bush problems playing this file. See media help. Speech example: an example of a Plains, Georgia male with a non-rhotic accent. Jimmy Carter problems playing this file. See media help. Speech example: an example of a southwestern Arkansas male with a rhotic accent. Bill Clinton problems playing this file. See media help. Contents: 1. Geography. 2. Phonology of the Southeastern Super Region. 21. The South. 211. Inland South and Texas. 22. Atlanta, Charleston, and Savannah. 23. Southern Louisiana. 231. Acadiana. 232. New Orleans. 3. Phonology of the Older South. 4. Grammar and Vocabulary. 41. Newer Features. 42. Shared Newer and Older Features. 5. Relationship to African American English. 6. See also. 7. Notes. 8. References. 9. Sources. 10. External links. Geography. The dialects collectively known as Southern American English stretch across the southeastern and south-central United States, but exclude the southernmost areas of Florida and the extreme western and southwestern parts of Texas, as well as the Rio Grande Valley, Laredo to Brownsville. This linguistic region includes Alabama, Georgia, Tennessee, Mississippi, North Carolina, South Carolina, Louisiana, and Arkansas, as well as most of Texas, Virginia, Kentucky, Oklahoma, West Virginia, and northern and central Florida. Southern American English dialects can also be found in extreme southern parts of Missouri, Maryland, Delaware, and Illinois. Southern dialects originated in large part from a mix of immigrants from the British Isles, who moved to the American South in the 17th and 18th centuries, and the Creole or post-Creole speech of African slaves. Upheavals such as the Great Depression, the Dust Bowl, and World War II caused mass migrations of those and other settlers throughout the United States. Phonology of the Southeastern Super Region. Blue represents major cities of the southern accent. Darker blue represents cities with the strongest features of this accent. Purple represents the related Midland accent, which together with the southern accent falls under the southeastern super region defined in this section. Red represents nearby cities outside of that super region. Headed by William LeBove, the 2006 Atlas of North American English NA identifies the South itself, as well a large area of states bordering all along the South, as constituting a southeastern super region, with even remote including arguably northern areas that phonologically exhibit some noticeable southern character. Essentially all of the modern-day southern dialects, plus dialects marginal to the South, are thus considered a subset of this super region. Thus, a modern southeastern dialectal super region is defined by essentially essentially the whole American South, including all of the Gulf region, even Florida, the Mid and South Atlantic regions, and a transitional Midland dialect area between the South and the North, lying above the strict Southern region and comprising most of Oklahoma, Kansas, Missouri, southeastern Nebraska, southern Illinois, southern Indiana, and southern Ohio. Put perhaps in clearer terms, the southeastern super dialect region encompasses all of these most general regional American dialects: Southern dialects, Midland dialect, Mid-Atlantic dialect, English of the areas inside or just outside the southern region, but without yet any well-studied, unique defining character, such as northern Florida. These are the minimal necessary features that identify a speaker from the southeastern super region, fronting of a and o, the gliding vowels a as in cow or ouch and o as in goat or bone both start considerably forward in the mouth, approximately and, respectively, o may even end in a very forward position, something like however. This fronting does not occur in younger speakers before l as in goal or colt, or before a syllable break between two vowels as in going or poet, in which o remains back in the mouth as lacking or transitioning cot-cot merger. The historical distinction between the two vowels sounds, and in words like cot and cot or stock and stock is mainly preserved in much of the South during the 1900s, there was a trend to lower the vowel found in words like stock and cot, often with an upglide, so that the most common result today is the gliding vowel. However, the cot-cot merger is becoming increasingly common throughout the United States, thus affecting southeastern and even some southern dialects, towards a merged vowel in the South. This merger, or a transition towards this merger, is especially documented in central, northern, and particularly western Texas card chord merger. The vowel in r, as in part or star, is often rounded to, perhaps even merging with r, so that words like stork and stark become identical in sound. The merger of pin and pen in Southern American English in the purple areas, the merger is complete for most speakers. Note the exclusion of the New Orleans area, Southern Florida, and of the Lowcountry of South Carolina and Georgia. The purple area in California consists of the Bakersfield and Kern County area, where migrants from the South Central states settled during the Dust Bowl. There is also debate whether or not Austin, Texas is an exclusion based on LeBove, Ash. R sounds are pronounced, has become dominant throughout the entire southeastern super region, as in most American English, and even more so among younger and female white southern speakers. The only major exception is among African American southerners, whose modern vernacular dialect continues to be mostly non-rhotic. The sound quality of the southern R is the distinctive bunch-tongued R, produced by strongly constricting the root end or midsection of the tongue. The south all, dog, bot, loss, saw, tot, preceding a nasal consonant, dress, met, bread, about, syrup, arena, hit, skim, tip, I, beam, chic, fleet, island, gamut, wasted, bus, flood, what, book, put, should, you, food, glue, new diphthongs, ah, ride, shine, try, bright, dice, psych, ah, now, ouch, scout, e, lake, paid, rain, boy, choice, moist, o, preceding, l, or a hiatus, goat, o, show, r, colored vowels, r. Rhotic Southern dialects, non-rhotic Southern dialects, barn, car, park, are, rhotic, non-rhotic, bear, bear, there, are, older, burn, first, heard, are, rhotic, non-rhotic, better, martyr, doctor, are, rhotic, non-rhotic, fear, peer, tear, are, rhotic, non-rhotic, horse, horse, poor score, tour, war, are, junior, rhotic, non-rhotic, pure, Europe, pure mean formant values for the ane subjects LeBove, Ash. Still actually wide variation in Southern speech regarding potential differences based on factors like a speaker's exact sub-region, age, ethnicity, etc. The following phonological phenomena focus on the developing sound system of the more recent Southern dialects of the United States that altogether largely though certainly not entirely superseded the older Southern regional patterns. Southern vowel shift or Southern shift, a chain shift regarding vowels is fully completed, or occurring, in most Southern dialects, especially younger ones, and at the most advanced stage in the inland south, i.e. away from the coastline, and Texas south, i.e. most of central and northern Texas. This three-stage chain movement of vowels, called the southern shift, is first triggered by stage 1 that dominates the entire southern region, followed by stage 2 that covers almost all of that area, and stage 3 that is concentrated only in speakers of certain core sub-regions. Stage 1 defined below may have begun in some southern dialects as early as the first half of the 1800s with a glide weakening of a, to or, however, it was still largely incomplete or absent in the mid-1800s, before expanding rapidly from the last quarter of the 1800s into the middle 1900s. Today, this glide weakening or even total glide deletion is the pronunciation norm throughout all of the southern United States. Stage 1, a, and a, the starting point, or first stage, of the southern shift is the transition of the gliding vowel diphthong, a. Like ya up stage 2, e, and, by removing the existence of, stage 1 leaves open a lower space for, e, as in name and day to occupy, causing stage 2, the pulling of the diphthong, e, into a lower starting position, towards. An example is that, to other English speakers, the southern pronunciation of fin sounds something like fee in, while meal sounds something like mih eel. Like the other stages of the southern shift, stage 3 is most common in heavily stressed syllables and particularly among inland southern speakers. Southern vowel breaking, southern drawl. All three stages of the southern shift often result in the short front pure vowels being broken into gliding vowels, making one syllable words like pet and pit sound as if they might have two syllables as something like pay it and it respectively. This short front vowel gliding phenomenon is popularly recognized as the southern drawl. The short a, short e, and short I vowels are all affected, developing a glide up from their original starting position to, and then often back down to a schwa vowel, a, and, respectively. This phenomenon is on the decline, being most typical of southern speakers born before 1960, though mostly after the mid-1800s. Unstressed, word final, the phoneme in an unstressed syllable at the end of a word fronts to, so that singing s is sometimes written phonetically as singin. This is common in vernacular English dialects around the world. Lax and tense vowels often neutralize before l, making pairs like feel, fill, and fail, fell homophones for speakers in some areas of the South. Some speakers may distinguish between the two sets of words by reversing the normal vowel sound, e.g., feel in southern may sound like fill, and vice versa. The back vowel, u, in goose or true is fronted in the mouth to the vicinity of, or even farther forward, which is then followed by a slight gliding quality. Different gliding qualities have been reported, including both backward and especially in the eastern half of the South. Forward glides back up glide chain shift. In southern regional and southeastern super-regional dialects, a shifts forward and upward to also possibly realized, variously, as, thus allowing the back vowel to fill an area similar to the former position of a in the mouth, becoming lowered and developing an upglide. This, in turn, allows, though only for the most advanced southern speakers, the upgliding before l to lose its glide, for instance, causing the word boils to sound something like the British or New York City pronunciations of. Many nouns are stressed on the first syllable that are stressed on the second syllable in most other American accents. These may include police, cement, Detroit, Thanksgiving, insurance, behind, display, hotel, motel, recycle, TV, guitar, July, and umbrella. Today, younger Southerners tend to keep this initial stress for a more reduced set of words, perhaps including only insurance, defense, and umbrella. Lacking or incomplete happy tensing, the tensing of unstressed, word final, the second vowel sound in words like happy, money, Chelsea, etc. to a higher and fronter vowel like is typical throughout the United States, except in the South. The South maintains a sound not obviously tensed, or words ending in unstressed, o, may be pronounced more like, making yellow sound like yella or tomorrow like tomorrow. Inland South and Texas main articles, Appalachian English and Texan English. ANA identifies the Inland South as a large linguistic area of the South located mostly in southern Appalachia, specifically naming the cities of Greenville, South Carolina, Asheville, NC, Knoxville and Chattanooga, TN, and Birmingham and Linden, AL, inland from both the Gulf and Atlantic coasts, and the originating region of the southern vowel shift. The Inland South, along with the Texas South, an urban core of Central Texas, Dallas, Lubbock, Odessa, and San Antonio are considered the two major locations in which the southern regional sound system is the most evolved, and therefore the core areas of the current-day South as a dialect region. The accents of Texas are actually diverse, for example with important Spanish influences on its vocabulary. However, much of the state is still an unambiguous region of modern rhotic southern speech, strongest in the cities of Dallas, Lubbock, Odessa, and San Antonio, which all firmly demonstrate the first stage of the southern shift, if not also further stages of the shift. Texas Texan cities that are noticeably non-Southern dialectally are Abilene and Austin. Only marginally Southern are Houston, El Paso, and Corpus Christi in western and northern Texas. The Cott-Cott merger is very close to completed Atlanta, Charleston, and Savannah. The Atlas of North American English identifies Atlanta, Georgia as a dialectal island of non-Southern speech. Charleston, South Carolina likewise is not markedly Southern in character, and the traditional local accent of Savannah, Georgia as giving way to regional patterns. Despite these being three prominent Southern cities, the dialect features of Atlanta are best described today as sporadic from speaker to speaker, with such variation increased due to a huge movement of non-Southerners into the area during the 1990s. Modern-day Charleston speakers have leveled in the direction of a more generalized Midland accent, away the city's now defunct but traditional Lowcountry accent, whose features were diametrically opposed to the Southern shift and differ in many other respects from the main body of Southern dialects. The Savannah accent is also becoming more Midland, like the following vowel sounds of Atlanta, Charleston, and Savannah have been unaffected by typical Southern phenomena like the Southern drawl and Southern vowel shift. A, as in bad. The default general American nasal short a system is in use, in which A is tensed only before N or per meter. A, as in bide. However, some Atlanta and Savannah speakers do variably show Southern A glide weakening. E, as in bait, as in bed, as in bid. I, as in bead, as in bought, which is lowered, as in most of the U.S., and approaches. The Cott-Cott merger is mostly at a transitional stage in these cities. However, the modern accents of Atlanta, Charleston, and Savannah do incorporate many of the general southeastern super-regional features listed above and can be regarded roughly as varieties of Midland English. Some speakers from all three cities, though most consistently Charleston and least consistently in Savannah, demonstrate the southeastern fronting of O. The status of the Pin-Pen merger is highly variable in all three cities. Non-roticity R dropping is now rare in these cities, yet still documented in some speakers. Southern Louisiana, as well as some of southeast Texas, Houston to Beaumont, and coastal Mississippi, feature a number of dialects influenced by other languages beyond English. Most of southern Louisiana constitutes Acadiana, dominated for hundreds of years by monolingual speakers of Cajun French, which combines elements of Acadian French with other French and Spanish words. This French dialect is spoken by many of the older members of the Cajun ethnic group and is said to be dying out. A related language called Louisiana Creole also exists. Acadiana main article, Cajun English. Since the early 1900s, Cajuns of southern Louisiana, though historically monolingual French speakers, began to develop their own vernacular dialect of English, which retains some influences and words from Acadian, Cajun French, such as cher dear or nonk uncle. This dialect fell out of fashion after World War II, but experienced a renewal in primarily male speakers born since the 1970s, who have been the most appealed by, and the biggest appealers for, a successful Cajun cultural renaissance. Speakers of Cajun vernacular English demonstrate these major features, among many others: non-roticity or R-dropping, for the most part high nasalization, even in vowels before nasal consonants, deletion of any word's final consonants. Examples are that hand becomes, food becomes, rent becomes, New York becomes, and so on. Universal glide weakening, a particular process of glide weakening is common in the South for certain gliding vowels. However, Cajun English is distinct in that every single English gliding vowel is subject to glide weakening or deletion. For instance, O, as in Joe, E, as in Jay, and as in joy have somewhat or entirely reduced glides, and, respectively. Cott-Cott merger towards New Orleans main article, New Orleans English. One historical English dialect spoken only by those raised in the greater New Orleans area is non-rhotic and noticeably shares more pronunciation commonalities due to very strong historical ties with the New York accent than with other Southern accents since at least the 1980s. This local New Orleans dialect has popularly been called yacht, from the common local greeting, where you at? The New York City English features shared with this dialect include non-roticity short a split system, so that bad and back, for example, have different vowels, as high, often with a glide, r, as rounded coil curl merger traditionally, though now in decline. Yacht also lacks the typical vowel changes of the southern shift and the pin-pen merger that are commonly heard elsewhere throughout the South. Yacht is associated with the working and lower middle classes, though a spectrum with fewer notable yacht features is often heard. The higher one's socioeconomic status, such New Orleans affluence is associated with the New Orleans Uptown and the Garden District, and its speech patterns are sometimes considered a separate variety altogether from the Yacht dialect. Additionally, many unique terms such as neutral ground for the median of a divided street Louisiana, Southern Mississippi, or banquet for a sidewalk Southern Louisiana, Eastern Texas are found in New Orleans and elsewhere in coastal Louisiana. Phonology of the Older South Main article, Older Southern American English. Prior to becoming a phonologically unified dialect region, the South was once home to an array of much more diverse accents at the local level. Features of the deeper interior South largely became the basis for the newer Southern regional dialect and Southeastern super-regional dialect discussed above. Thus, Older Southern American English primarily refers to the English spoken in the coastal and former plantation areas of the South, best documented before the Civil War, on the decline during the early 1900s, and basically non-existent in speakers born since the Civil Rights era. Very little unified these older Southern dialects, since they never formed a single homogeneous dialect region to begin with. Some older Southern accents were rhotic most strongly in Appalachia and west of the Mississippi, while the majority were non-rhotic most strongly in plantation areas. However, wide variation existed. Some older Southern accents showed or approximated stage 1 of the Southern vowel shift, namely, the glide weakening of ah. However, it is virtually unreported before the very late 1800s in general. The older Southern dialects clearly lacked the merry merry merry, cot caught, horse horse, wine wine, full fool, fill feel, and do do mergers, all of which are now common to, or encroaching on, all varieties of present-day Southern American English. Older Southern sound systems included those local to plantation South. The Black Belt, excluding the Lowcountry, phonologically characterized by ah, glide weakening, non-rhoticity for some accents, including a coil-curl merger, and the Southern trap bath split, a version of the trap bath split unique to older Southern U.S. speech that causes words like last not to rhyme with words like pass. Eastern and Central Virginia, often identified as the Tidewater accent, further characterized by Canadian raising and some vestigial resistance to the vein-vein merger. Lowcountry of South Carolina and Georgia, often identified as the traditional Charleston accent, characterized by no, ah, glide weakening, non-rhoticity including the coil-curl merger. The Southern trap bath split, Canadian raising, the chair-chair merger, e, pronounced as, and, o, pronounced as Outer Banks and Chesapeake Bay, often identified as the hoi-toiter accent, characterized by no, ah, glide weakening with the unglide strongly backed, unlike any other U.S. dialect, the card-chord merger, ah, pronounced as, and upgliding of pure vowels especially before, making fish sound almost like fish and ash like ish. It is the only dialect of the older South still extant on the East Coast, due to being passed on through generations of geographically isolated islanders. Appalachian and Ozark Mountains, characterized by strong rhoticity and a tour-tour-tour merger which still exist in that region. The Southern trap bath split, plus the original and most advanced instances of the Southern vowel shift now defining the whole South grammar and vocabulary. Newer features frequency of either y'all or you-all to address multiple people, according to an internet survey of American dialect variation frequency of just y'all to address multiple people, according to an internet survey of American dialect variation use of the contraction y'all as the second person plural pronoun its uncombined form. Group represented by an addressee are included, that is, it operates in contradistinction to some of y'all, thereby functioning similarly to all of you in standard English. In rural Southern Appalachia, an n is added to pronouns indicating one. Hisson, his one. Herin, her one. Yourin, your one, i.e., his, hers and yours. Another example is yearns's. It may be substituted for the second person plural possessive yours. That book is yearns's, j-r-n-z-z, use of dove as past tense for dive, drug as past tense for drag, brung as past tense for bring, and drunk as past tense for drink. Shared newer and older features. These grammatical features are characteristic of both older Southern American English and newer Southern American English. Use of done as an auxiliary verb between the subject and verb in sentences conveying the past tense I done told you before. Use of done instead of did as the past simple form of do, and similar uses of the past participle in place of the past simple, such as seen replacing saw as past simple form of see. I only done what you done told me. I seen her first. Use of other non-standard preterites, such as drowned it as the past tense of drown, knowed as past tense of know, choose it as the past tense of choose, degraded it as the past tense of degrade I knowed you for a fool soon as I seen you use of was in place of were, or other words regularizing the past tense of be to was you was sittin' on that chair use of been instead of have been in perfect constructions I been livin' here darn near my whole life use of double modals might could, might should, might would, used to could, etc. also called modal stacking and sometimes even triple modals that involve oughta like might should oughta I might could climb to the top I used to could do that use of a fixin' to, or just fixing to in more modern Southern, to indicate immediate future action in place of intending to, preparing to, or about to he's fixin' to eat there fixing to go for a hike. Preservation of older English me, him, etc. as reflexive datives I'm fixin' to paint me a picture he's gonna catch him a big one saying this here in place of this or this one, and that there in place of that or that one this here's mine and that there is yours existential it, a feature dating from Middle English which can be explained as substituting it for there when there refers to no physical location, but only to the existence of something it's one lady that lives in town use of ever in place of every everywhere's the same these days use of over yonder in place of over there or in or at that indicated place, especially to refer to a particularly different spot, such as in the house over yonder. Additionally, yonder tends to refer to a third, larger degree of distance beyond both here and there, indicating that something is a longer way away, and to a lesser extent, in a wide or loosely defined expanse, as in the church hymn when the roll is called up yonder relationship to African American English main article, African American Vernacular English discussion of Southern dialect in the United States popularly refers to those English varieties spoken by white Southerners, however, as a geographic term, it may also encompass the dialects developed among other social or ethnic groups in the South, most prominently including African Americans today. African American Vernacular English AAVE is a fairly unified variety of English spoken by working and middle-class African Americans throughout the United States. AAVE exhibits an evident relationship with both older and newer Southern dialects, though the exact nature of this relationship is poorly understood. It is clear that AAVE was influenced by older speech patterns of the southern United States, where Africans and African Americans were held as slaves until the American Civil War. These slaves originally spoke a diversity of indigenous African languages but picked up English to communicate with one another, their white masters, and the white servants and laborers they often closely worked alongside. Many features of AAVE suggest that it largely developed from non-standard dialects of colonial English, with some features of AAVE absent from other modern American dialects, yet still existing in certain modern British dialects. However, there is also evidence of the influence of West African languages on AAVE vocabulary and grammar. It is uncertain to what extent early white Southern English borrowed elements from early African American English versus the other way around, like many white accents of English once spoken in Southern plantation areas, namely, the Lowcountry, Virginia Piedmont and Tidewater, Lower Mississippi Valley, and Western Black Belt. The modern-day AAVE accent is mostly non-rhotic or r-dropping. The presence of non-rhoticity in both Black English and older white Southern English is not merely coincidence, though, again, which dialect influenced which is unknown. It is better documented, however, that white Southerners borrowed some morphological processes from Black Southerners. Many grammatical features were used alike by older speakers of white Southern English and African American English, more so than by contemporary speakers of the same two varieties. Even so, contemporary speakers of both continue to share these unique grammatical features. Existential it, the word y'all, double negatives, was to mean were, deletion of had and have, them to mean those, the term fixin' to, stressing the first syllable of words like hotel or guitar, and many others. Both dialects also continue to share these same pronunciation features, tensing, raising, upgliding, the pin-pen merger, and the most defining sound of the current Southern accent, though rarely documented in older Southern accents, the glide weakening of ah. However, while this glide weakening has triggered among white Southerners a complicated Southern vowel shift, Black speakers in the South and elsewhere on the other hand are not participating or barely participating in much of this shift. AAVE speakers also do not front the vowel starting positions of o, and u, thus aligning these characteristics more with the speech of 19th century white Southerners than 20th century white Southerners. One strong possibility for the divergence of Black American English and white Southern American English, i.e., the disappearance of older Southern American English, is that the civil rights struggles caused these two racial groups to stigmatize linguistic variables associated with the other group. This may explain some of the differences outlined above, including why all traditionally non-rhotic white Southern accents have shifted to now becoming intensely rhotic. See also accent perception, African American English, Chicano English, drawl, high titer, regional vocabularies of American English, Southern literature, Texan English. Notes: carat, the only notable exceptions of the South being a subset of the southeastern super-region, are two Southern metropolitan areas, described as such because they participate in stage 1 of the Southern vowel shift, but lack the other defining southeastern features. Savannah, Georgia, and Amarillo, Texas. References: Carrot Thomas, 2006-4, 11. Carrot Stephen J. Nagel. Carrot, Do You Speak American? What Lies Ahead? PBS. Retrieved the 15th of August 2007. Carrot Labove, Ash. Carrot Labove, Ash. Carrot A. B. Labove, Ash. http://www.uaumedu/fll/linguistics/dialect/staticmaps/statesmel. Carat Harvard Dialect Survey, Word Use, a group of two or more people. Carat Hazen, Kirk and Fluherty, Ellen, Linguistic Diversity in the South, Changing Codes, Practices and Ideology, page 59, Georgia University Press, 1st edition, 2004, ISBN 0-8203-2586-4. Carat Regional Notes from the Free Dictionary. Carat Thomas, 2006-19. Carat Lanehart, Sonia L. Editor, 2001. Sociocultural and Historical Contexts of African American English. John Benjamin's Publishing, pp. 113-114. Carat Thomas, 2006-19-20. Carat Thomas, 2006-4. Carat Thomas, 2006-4. Sources: Bernstein, Cynthia, 2003. Grammatical Features of Southern Speech. In Stephen J. Nagel, Sarah L. Sanders, English in the Southern United States. Cambridge, Cambridge University Press. ISBN